students. It has
sir,
been
sir.
Yes.
Sir, subject verb agreement implies that the subject and the verb of a sentence must be agreement in terms of number.
You are just reading the definition given in points given in the book. Okay, no problem. Subject and verb agreement, student, is something that subject verb should be always used according to its subject. It means that if the subject is in a plural form, the verb should be also in the plural form. It means subject and verb should agreed in terms of number. For example, if I am using subject he, so in present continuous there are three helping verbs: is, which we can use, is, am, are. So since now it is confirmed that we are going to use subject he, so it should be clear, and the verb should be also according to the subject. It can't be like this that we can use are here, because subject is the third person and singular, so the verb should be also singular. So are is not a singular verb. Is a plural verb. So which verb we will use? Is. So subject verb agreement is all about, students, verb should be according to the, or verb should be used according to the subject's number. जो भी subjects का number होगा, whether the subject is singular or plural, according to that we will use the verb, and this is what we are going to study in this chapter. यही हमें पढ़ना है. So rules are given there in your book. So first I will try to first we will try to understand the rules, then we will study its related exercise. So first rule on the page number 28 and the fifth chapter is that, students, when the two subjects are joined by and, the verb will be plural. This is the first rule. When the two subjects are joined by conjunction and, then the verb should be plural. For example, Mohan and Shohan. Mohan and Shohan. So here, students, you can clearly see two subjects are there, and these two subjects have been joined with the help of conjunction and. So in such situations, if you are supposed to use the verb, then the verb should be in the always should be in the plural form. Verb bhi kya honi chahiye? Plural honi chahiye. For example, going to markets, and verb are given here are and is. So now in such situation, if somebody asks you, please choose the correct verb for this sentence. So what would be the correct verb? Now Mohan and Sohan, two subjects are there. They have been joined by conjunction and. So what would be the verb here? Are. Because now the subject is plural. Subject kya hai? I will first explain the rules, then we will study its exercise. So this is the first rule, students. I don't think there should be any problem for you. Let's talk about the second rule. Second rule says, students, when two singular nouns joined by and, two singular nouns joined by and refer to the same person or thing, the verb will be singular. Here, what the rule is saying, students, when the two singular nouns are joined by and refer to the same person, for example, the captain and coach. So students, you can clearly see again in this rule there are two singular nouns, like captain is the first noun, first subject you can say, and the coach is the another noun in this sentence. So both are singular, but these are the two captain coach, these are the two coach students, but it's referring to the same persons. It is not two different persons, like captain is someone is different and the coach is someone different. No, the both same person is the captain and same person is the coach as well. So maybe two nouns are there, but these two nouns are referring to the same person, because the same person having the both post, captain as well as the coach, dono ka post usi ke paas hai. So in such cases we don't need to be confused. If the two nouns joined by and referring to the same person or to one person or thing, then we need to use singular verb. So here we will use singular verb. Like if you want to say the captain and the coach gone somewhere, gone somewhere. So suppose two verbs have been given, has and have. So which verb we will use? Now, according to the rules, in such situation, if the two nouns are there, joined by the joined by and, and referring to the same person or one person, then we need to use singular. So here we will use singular verb, that is the has. So this is the second rule, students. Is it clear, or is any, there is any doubt? Second rule, samajh mein aaya?
Sorry.
Yes, sir.
Okay. One more thing. One more thing is there, which I would like to tell you. If in such situation, if you are confused, it means you are not able to understand that whether the two nouns are referring to the same person or the same thing. Then just with the help of article, you can also identify. If you see the two singular noun are there joined by and, and article has been used just before one, not the another one. Like in this sentence, you can clearly see article has been used just before the first noun, before the captain, not the coach. So in such situations, if article has been used before just one noun, it means that the both noun are referring to the same person or just to one person. For example, if I write like this, the coach and the captain, and the captain. So now here, the both here, you can clearly see we have used article before the both noun. But here now these two nouns are not referring to the same person. It means now the two nouns are referring to the two different peoples. Now captain is someone else and the coach is someone else, not the same person. So if the article is before both the noun, then they are referring to the two different person or people. And if the article is just before one, like this in this sentence, then it, you can understand, or you can say that it's referring to the same person. Okay. So this is how you can also identify just with the help of article if you are confused. Let me again tell you, when the article is before both the nouns, then it means they are referring to the two different peoples. So we will use plural verb. Here we will use plural noun. We can't say has, because now the captain is someone else and the coach is someone else. They are not the same persons. So here we will use, in such situation, we will use plural verb. So we will use have for the same sentence. Have gone somewhere. So I think it should be clear. So now we have studied two rules related to subject verb agreement. Now we will see the third rule. Let's see what does third rule says. Indefinite pronoun, we just finished the chapter pronoun. So we studied about the indefinite pronoun, like the words which shows something that is not definite. We are not certain about it. Like everyone, if you say everyone, we don't know that it doesn't refer to a particular person or thing. Similarly, everyone, someone, somebody, no one, nobody, anyone, the words are given. Indefinite words are given. So with indefinite pronouns, we always use singular verbs. Like if the word is somebody, and verb is has and have, so there should be no doubt in your mind. If, as you can clearly see, subject is in the form of indefinite pronoun, so wherever there is indefinite pronoun, we always use singular verb. So which verb will you choose? We will choose has, because the has is the singular verb. It is very simple. I don't think there should be any problem. Now let's talk about the, yes, there is one exception, students. There are also some indefinite pronouns which are always plural, like a few, some. It is given several, etc. It is given in your book. You can clearly see both, all, some. So with these indefinite pronoun, we need to use plural, because they always refer to the plurals noun. Inke saath hum kis noun ka use karte hain? Plural noun ka. Like for example, few of the students, few of them, and suppose dash is there, absent. Option is and are. So since you can clearly see the few indefinite pronoun we have used, so it refers to the plurals in numbers. Ye plurals numbers ko dikhate hain. So with these indefinite pronoun, ये जो indefinite pronoun है, with these we will use plural verb. इनके साथ हम किसका use करेंगे? Plural verb का. So here we will use are. But with the rest of the indefinite pronoun, we will use singular verb. So we have also finished third rules. Now we will talk about the fourth. When a percentage or part of something is mentioned with the plural meaning, the plural verb is used. Like if you want to say 40%, 40% students present. So when there, you know, percentage or part of something is mentioned and that which is plural. So 40 is something students, plural form. You can also see this example in your book. So in such situation, we again use which verb, plural verb. So if suppose two options are here, was and were, so simply which verb we will use? Plural verb, that is were. So it's very, again, simple rules. Yes, another rule is there, students, along with either and or. If the two singular noun are there, suppose that two singular noun are there and which have been joined along with either or neither nor. For example, either you are or your friend for this mistake. So students, in such situations, there are two subjects. First one is you and second one is your friend. So it might cause confusion for you that it's maybe difficult for you, or you might face some problem choosing the verb for in such situation. Is tarah ki situation mein verb chunna thoda sa mushkil ho jayega. For example, two options are there. Is and are. So rule says that, students, if format is like this, like we have joined the two subjects along with the help of either and or, then in such situation we should use verb according to the subject that is nearest to the verb. Like you is here, so after you here already or is there, so you can't write verb here. So which subject would be nearest to the verb? Your friend. So in such situation, we will use verb according to the subject that would be nearest to the verb. Jo kiske kareeb hoga? Verb ke kareeb. So here you can say after your friend, we need to use the verb. So in such situation, we will use verb according to the subject that would be the nearest to the verb. So here we will not use verb according to this one, this subject, because it's not near to the verb. We will use verb according to this subject. So here the right verb would be is, because your friend is third person and singular one. Let me give you one more example. Neither he nor his friends playing cricket. So if you have understood the rule, students, and suppose option is there, were and was, so you can clearly choose the right verb. So let me also allow you to speak so that you can clearly understand, and if there is any doubt you can ask. Now you tell me, students, in such situation or here in the blank space, which verb we will use?
Sir, was.
Was, why? Can you tell me why we will use was? There are two verbs or two subjects, beg your pardon, his friends and he. So in such situation, according to which subject we use the verb?
Sir, according to the subject was the verb hoga.
Look, don't be confused.
Sir,
in such format, we use verb according to the subject that is nearest. So ye subject near hoga verb ke ki his friends near hoga. His friends hoga, because here we need to use the verb. So his friends is the plural subject. कौन सा subject है?
No sir.
So plural. Plural verb.
Plural.
We will use plural verb was. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Rule
samajh gaya? Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Now the next rule. I don't need to just write on the board to explain this rule. Just if you see a number has been mentioned in the beginning of a sentence, a number or the number of, then you need to use the plural verb. Us case mein hume kaun si verb use karni hoti hai? Plural verb use karni hoti hai. When units of measurements are time, jab bhi unit of measurements ki baat hogi to hum singular verb ka use karenge, like 5 liters, 5 kg, like this. Few, many, several, both. अभी हमने डिस्कस किया था दैट इफ द इंडेफिनिट प्रोनाउन आर देयर लाइक अ फ्यू, सम, ऑल, देन वी नीड टू यूज प्लूरल वर्ब. सो आई डोंट थिंक देयर शुड बी एनी प्रॉब्लम फॉर एनीवन. नाउ वी विल डिस्कस द फर्स्ट एक्सरसाइज स्टूडेंट्स रिलेटेड टू दिस दीज रूल्स. इन रूल्स से रिलेटेड पहला एक्सरसाइज हम लोग देख लेते हैं. एक्सरसाइज ए, इट्स वेरी सिंपल. इफ यू हैव अंडरस्टूड द रूल, नाउ यू कैन क्लियरली अटेम्प्ट बाय योरसेल्फ. अपने आप भी अटेम्प्ट आप कर सकते हैं, देयर शुड बी नो प्रॉब्लम. Everyone, what is the everyone?
Once.
It is the indefinite pronoun. Everyone.
Yes, indefinite, sir. Indefinite pronoun.
So with indefinite pronoun like everyone, somebody.
Someone.
Which verb is used? Singular verb is used.
One.
Singular.
So what would be the right option in the first sentence?
Wants.
So please stick wants.
Wants.
Wants. Okay. The verb. It's. One, there is very strange rule in English grammar, students. When we make a noun plural, we add s, like boy is a noun. So if you want to make plural of the boy, what we do? We use s. But opposite rule is opposite in case of verb, students. When we want to make a verb singular, we add s, like if I have written go. So here the verb is plural. Without s, it is plural. But as I write goes, yes, now it has become singular. So rule ulta hai. Noun ko plural banane ke liye hume s jodna padta hai, aur verb ko plural banane ke liye hume usme se s hatana padta hai. Singular banane ke liye jodna padta hai. Clear?
Yes.
Okay. Now let's talk about the second sentence.
Yes, sir.
Harish and Ranjan goes to the movie or went to
sir,
the movie.
Sir, went movie.
Harish and Ranjan.
Second. Sir goes.
Sir went.
Ranjan. Now, students, there are two nouns joined by and, so the
verb went.
Sir went.
Sir went.
Went would be the right option.
Went
would be the right options. Clear?
Yes, sir.
In the third sentence, most of the money. What would be the right option?
Was.
Most was or were lost.
Sir, was.
When the uncountable noun is there, we need to use singular verb. So the right option would be was.
Was.
Clear?
Was.
In the fourth sentence, yes, the number of soldiers. Already rule was there that if the number of or
sir,
number of as you mentioned, then we
border.
Need to use plural. So in the fourth sentence, the right option would be
are.
Similarly, in the fifth sentence, the committee. So committee is singular subject, student. So we need to use singular verb. So what would be the right option?
Is.
Prabhu often. Prabhu is again singular, third person singular verb. So verb subjects. So again, verb singular.
Then
place.
Sir, place.
Yes.
Sir, often. कौन सा होगा? कौन सा?
Often is adverb. It's not a subject. Often जो है. वो सब नाउन नहीं है, ये एडवर्ब है. सो ऑफ्टन विल नॉट बी टेकन इनटू द कंसीडरेशन. द टेस्ट ऑफ दिस मैंगोस
आर
वी आर नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट द मैंगोस
सर, इज खाइंग.
सो टेस्ट इज द सिंगुलर अनकाउंटेबल. So we are talking about the taste. So the right option is we are not talking about mangoes. Mangoes के बारे में बात नहीं कर रहे, taste के बारे में बात कर रहे हैं, which is singular one. And sentence 8, I. What's the right option?
I drink.
नहीं होगा.
Drink.
It should not be drinks. Drink. Just simple drink.
Drink.
Have you all completed or written? लिख लिया सभी लोग?
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Okay, now let's see the another exercise.
Yes sir.
I have already taught you tense and these questions are related to the tense students.
Sir, two question hai abhi.
Do question aur hai.
Yes sir, 9 or 10
sentences. My mother is the again third person singular. So singular verb is there.
Bakes.
No, it
bakes.
Singular bakes. Bakes hoga.
Bakes.
Number 10 of Venice.
Sir, is.
It's the name of a person.
Is
would be the right option. So let's discuss the exercise B now, student. Who is there?
Plural pronoun hai na.
Yes, what you are asking? Ask your question again. Let's discuss exercise B, student. We need to. Akansha, please make sure sound is coming from your side. Whatever discussion is going on there.
क्या होगा? Sir, question number 10 में क्या होगा? Is.
Tenth में option जो है is would be the right option. Circle the correct word. 100 rupees is or not a lot of money. Which would be the right verb? In the first sentence, which one is the right verb? 100 rupees is or not a lot of money.
There is.
Circle verb is. Another second sentence, students. We need to encircle the verb. Gymnastics is or easy for
is
again is
easy
for
circle is in the third sentence. 20 minutes again. We are talking about the amount. No, not are again
is.
20 minutes is because we are talking about amount of time. So if you are talking about the amount of time, we always need to use singular verb. A kilo of rice. Again, we need to use singular verb.
Costs.
Costs.
Yes.
S would be there. Costs.
Cost.
And in the fifth sentence,
cost.
Do not.
Clear? Any problem?
Yes, sir.
No, sir.
Okay, now we will talk
about exercise
C.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, when subject is singular, we use singular verb.
Repeat again.
Sir, when subject is singular, we use plural verb.
No, we don't use. If the subject is singular, obviously we will use the singular verb. But problem is that when we use singular verb, we add s or es in present. And while when we make plural of the noun or subjects, we use s. So, थोड़ा सा उससे आपको confusion हो जा रहा होगा. जब वर्ब में एस और यस यूज होता है देन वर्ब्स बिकम सिंगुलर, तब वर्ब सिंगुलर होती है. ओके
सर, आई सिंगुलर है या प्लुरल?
आई इज द सिंगुलर, बट रूल इज दैट इन द ग्रामर दैट विथ आई यू जस्ट नीड टू यूज नो, आई इज द सिंगुलर, बट प्रॉब्लम इज दैट इट्स नॉट द फर्स्ट थर्ड पर्सन इन ग्रामर. रूल इज देयर दैट वी नीड टू यूज सिंगुलर वर्ब विद द फर्स्ट विद द थर्ड पर्सन एंड सिंगुलर वन. So singular it is the singular, but it is not the third person, it is the first person. That's why we use the plural verb with the I. Clear? Yes. Samajh mein aaya? फॉर एग्जाम्पल
यस सर
आई हैव टेकन फूड आई हैव टेकन फूड सो ही हैज टेकन फूड सो इन दिस सेंटेंस स्टूडेंट I is no doubt I is the singular. He is also singular. Both are singular, but we have used plural verb with the I and singular verb with the has problem because I is singular, but it is not the third person. Two for the singular verb, the subject needs to be the third person and singular as well. Third person bhi hona chahiye aur singular bhi hona chahiye. Clear?
Okay, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
We will see the exercise C. Already options are there. Just you need to choose the correct option. They. So they is which is the plural subjects. So we need to use
has.
Plural verb. So
has
plural have.
Has.
Has.
Not
has.
Plural one. So have is the plural verb. So have would be the right option. Second sentence. Is the peon. Now the subject is singular students, so we need to use the singular verb.
Rings.
In the third sentence, I again, it's singular, but sir, it's not
I
third
do.
Person. So do.
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 Use
I do.
Do. In the fourth sentence, quite easy. What would be the right option?
I am.
I am.
And in the fifth sentence, he.
He does.
Right option. Similarly, in the sixth sentence, she has.
Is
the third person singular one? So singular verb is
has.
Now we will see the seventh sentence. The train again. The train is singular.
Arrives.
Yes, would be there in the verb to make it singular. Let's talk about the eighth sentence. I will inform you when she. Again, she is the third person singular. So verb would be
comes.
Singular verb would be there. So it is comes. The earth again singular verb.
Revolves.
Yes, would be there, students. Revolves. Tenth sentence.
Third one.
Because the earth is singular. Yes. Ask your question.
There is
fire. Is there any doubt?
There is fire.
The earth is the singular subject. That
no,
we have used the singular verb. Now let's talk about the sentence tense. She is again
aspires.
Singular.
Aspires.
Yes, would be there in the verb to make it singular. Aspires, so the right option. Sentence 11th. The people standing there. Now the people is plural students. So plural verb we need to use are. Would be the
people standing there are our
right
relatives.
Option. Clear? Now let's see the last sentence.
Yes, sir.
Let's wait till Vani.
Finishes.
Vani is singular.
Finishes.
Yes, finishes.
Finishes.
Would be the right option. So, is there any doubt in this exercise?
No, sir.
There is no doubt.
No, sir.
Okay. All right. Now let's see the last exercise. Exercise D.
सर वाणी
यस आस्क योर क्वेश्चन व्हाट डू यू वांट
टू आस्क सर टेल में क्या होगा
वेल
क्वेश्चन
फिनिशेस एफ आई एन आई एस एच ई एस फिनिशेस
सर क्या फील हुई था
ऑलरेडी ऑप्शन स्टूडेंट्स यस इज समवन आस्किंग एनीथिंग कोई कुछ पूछ रहा है
सर नाइन्थ में क्या पूछा?
आई हैड रिटन ऑन द बोर्ड नाइन्थ सेंटेंस सी व्हाट इज द सब्जेक्ट द अर्थ द सब्जेक्ट इज सिंगुलर थर्ड पर्सन रिवॉल्व्स Let's talk about exercise D students. Option is there. Mathematics is the name of a subject. Already S is there. So don't be confused because it's the name of a subject. So verb would be singular. So what would be the right option? Is would be the right option.
Mathematics
is. Is. Again, third person singular.
Does.
He does. Harish bicycle was
stolen.
Yes, it is third
stolen.
Person.
Stolen.
Have you not? Again, present perfect. Which verb we use? Verb third form. So right option would be finish. ED would be there.
Finished.
Third person. Fifth sentence.
Do.
The tigers and tigers and goats. Plural.
Does
bar,
not.
Does not.
Do. Plural subject. So plural is do.
Plural.
Do is the plural verb. Does is the singular student. So if the subject is
plural, yes,
we need to use plural verb. So do is plural, not does. Ramesh as well as his sisters. Students, when as well as is there in the sentence, jab bhi as well as ka use hota hai, and two subjects are there, the two subjects, then we use the verb according to the first subject. Jab bhi sentence mein as well as use hua ho, and two verbs are there, students, we need to use verbs according to the first subject. So what is the first subject? Ramesh. So Ramesh. Is the first person singular. Ramesh. So we will use the singular verb. So right option
is.
Let's talk about the seventh sentence. No news. News already S is there, but it's a singular. Don't be confused. News. उसमें
there is there,
but it's not there plural. Plural नहीं है, singular होता है. So we will use just singular.
Is
would be the right option. Not only the students, but also their instructor. So in such cases, students, when the not only has been used and there are two subjects, we use verb according to the subject that is nearest. So the which the verb instructor. So
instructor
will use has verb
has.
Has instructor is the subject person. Subject bigger part third person
has been called to the director's office.
Let's talk about the ninth sentence. None of my friends. When the none of my friends, none is already there, students. So with this, we use the singular verb. None अगर है sentence में, उसके साथ किसका use करते हैं हम लोग? Singular verb का.
Singular verb.
Yes. So was would be the right option.
Was.
Do not use the verb according to the friends. If none is there, verb should be singular. Let's talk about the 10th sentence. Rice and curry. Two different nouns are there, but referring to the same thing, students. It's referring to the food. In such situation,
sir,
we again use singular verb. Is tarah ki situation mein bhi hum kaun sa verb use karte hain? Singular verb. So the right option is not are. Right option is is.
Is. Is.
Would be the right option here. Now sentence 11th. Many
sir, लेकिन यहाँ पर is क्यों use करेंगे?
Yes, you are asking
क्योंकि दोनों food है ना?
Yes, दोनों food है. Yes, कोई जवाब अच्छा मिला. Now students, now listen. Okay. So is the right option. Now students, when we use many students, so when many is alone there. A has not been followed, then we use plural verb. But if just after many, article A has been used, A ka, then we use singular verb. Us case mein hum kaun sa verb use karte hain? सिंगुलर वर्ब यूज करते हैं. सो हियर वी विल यूज द सिंगुलर वर्ब. सिंगुलर वर्ब का यूज होगा. सो व्हाट इज द सिंगुलर वर्ब इन द
सर एक बार और बता दीजिए.
नाउ लिसन अगेन.
और एक बार
इफ
सर और बता दीजिए.
मेनी हैज बीन मेनी अलोन. अगर मेनी का यूज अलोन हुआ है लाइक मेनी स्टूडेंट्स.
सर हैव.
सो क्लियरली यू कैन सी आई हैव नॉट यूज्ड ए बट इफ मेनी इज फॉलोड बाय ए मेनी योर स्टूडेंट्स. Many are students. So in such situation, first situation we use singular verb. इस तरह की situation में कौन सी verb use करते हैं? Singular verb. जब many के बाद a आ जाए तो verb singular use होगी. Get clear?
Okay sir.
So here we will use singular verb. So what is the singular verb? Has.
Has
would be the right option. How much time is left? Yes, we can complete this exercise. Collecting poster stamps. Collecting is here, students. Collecting is something. Subject is singular. So verb
is. Is.
Is.
Is
would be the right option. It's a sentence. 12. Beg your pardon. 13. The police. Police is plural, students. Don't be confused.
There is. Plural?
No, we will use plural verb.
Are.
Police is always plural, so don't be confused. Plural verb will be used with it. The data of population. We are talking about data, which is singular, students. So the singular verb will be used. So right verb would be
is.
Now we have finished all the exercises of this chapter. Is there any doubt?
Yes, sir.
Sir, I ED can jude.
Yes, aap bataiye. In the here we are talking about finished.
Yes, sir.
Because it is the present perfect. The sentence is in the present perfect, and in present perfect we use verb third form. That's why we have used ED. Yes. So now, students, is there any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay, students. No, sir. Next week we will start the new chapters. Till then, students, have a good day. Take care. Thank you very much.